Python. First is object-oriented programming is very interesting. Remember, the object-oriented programming is only part of a Python. In Java, object-oriented programming is the main portion. There's no other procedural programming or functional programming, but Python object-oriented programming was the only feature. So here we defined a class person, and this is the, it is the constructor. How do you know constructor? Because double underscore e, double, this is the constructor, and these are the parameters. Save dot first term is the first name, save dot last name, this is the parameter, I give last, okay. Then I give the name of the person, this is a function, you know, and this is another class I am doing, class employee, and base class is person. The employee is a base class. I initialize it with this, and employee, I extra have employee self, and I have a person E, person Alex, and Carlos is his title, and employee Alex Cartel has, is it maybe ID number. Let's print name and print b.getEmployee. So I have a two class, one is a person, and let's run this program to our PyCharm, and both will run it both in PyCharm and this thing. So we come here, this is a PyCharm. PyCharm is a community edition. Please download it, PyCharm community edition. It will be free and it will level. So we just start this, we run this class person. We say this is the keyword, is different color. This is the base, this is the derived class. In Java, it is written as class employee extended as, and but I think Python is much simpler. The base class within a bracket, and this is a constructor. And remember, only one constructor will run. Whenever the child class, only this, not the parent one. And this is the, another method we have done. Then we just run this. Yeah, so it is running the Alex Carlos and Alex Carlos 1.01A102. So we know how to, A is a base class and B is a another from the derived class. Okay. Let's start with, let's go for another. We can run this interestingly. If you're interested to know whether it, how it's fair in Colab, Colab is a little bit slower. We can run it so that Colab is also, you can depend on it. So if you run it on Colab, say here, we just copy plus code. I just paste the code here. I hope I nothing have to do. I just run this code in Colab, and it is running fine. So without any change, you can run the code both in Colab and in your machine. Sometimes whenever the huge data is there, maybe Colab is better. Otherwise, your machine is PyCharm or PyDev or any other Anaconda, anything you can use it. Yes, then I go for another interesting program. This is a very interesting program. I hope you should feel it. Yeah, I think yes. Yeah. This one. This one, we have a class super, it's base class. Is super. With it, what is object? Object is always a parent class, as in Java and in Python. So the super is a class, object is a parent class, and we have defined implicit function self, which works on it. Print super class with implicit function, and then another defined class, class sub, and which is the base class is super. So sub is a derived class from super. And I do nothing. So that is another interesting instruction is there, pass. So whenever you are making a function, you have not yet decided what is to be done. You can reserve this sort by pass. That's, pass is an interesting command. So that you can fill up the blank later. And now you super, you create objects SU, just super. You create object of super class, and you create a base class object with a sub. Then you call su.implicit and sb.implicit. What is to be done? See here, implicit we have not defined in our base class. See here, we have, so it will be called the parent class implicit. That is interesting. So that is a very interesting feature of object-oriented programming. So if you have, you have not whatever the parent class, if you have not defined anything in the base class, if the base class it is not found, it will automatically go to the parent class and it will fire from there. So we should run this program. So we copy the program from here and we run it and we just yes and we paste, and this is our program and this is our run main. Yeah, see the result. Superclass with implicit function comes and superclass with implicit function comes. So even if you call it from base class like sb.implicit, it will come the superclass with implicit function because I have not defined any function in subclass. Automatically it will go to the superclass and this method will be bring down. Now this is a little bit of object-oriented programming. Now I think now we can go a little bit of how to handle file handling in Python. So let's start. This is the code I am sharing. I'll give the code. This is typically like C, a handle, A4, open sample.plex with write and binary file, WB, print file name, A4.name, what is the name, print mode of operating A4.mode, print is closed, whether it's closed on A4.closed. Write text data to file, say like sample. I write open the sample.files is open as a if. If dot write, hi there, there's a first line of, I can say hi there. I can write it here, little bit interesting. CAC 2024, section A, group 2. Yeah. So this is the first line of file. And this is the first line, this is the second line. Read the entire line. Line, data free, iterate over line, doing anything you can open it and now we have open and process the lines. Okay, I should have closed. Let's see if I missed anything else. I should have otherwise it will okay. If open, but I should close the file. Okay, it will run. We can see the visitor, our original where I am taken out, inheritance is a Python. You have seen Python regular expression, Python file handling. Python file handling. Copying the program here, I should have missed anything. Close. If I close, it is there. Process the line if dot read. Identify, that's all. If we go there, I think better you should copy this. If I close, or you can make it in a try catch block, try block. Better to be there. Let's see. So we put it here, process the lines. Here I should add this in a try block. Yeah, open a file. I think sample.ts. I again trying to open just to see anything. It should be indented, perform file operation. Finally, altris finally means it always will be executed. F of close. Okay. Now it's, I think it's a decent program. We just copy it and run it, our PyCharm. All the source code is given in this site. Hope so it will run. It is, yeah, it is running, great. So file name, sample.txt, mode of operating write and binary mode. Is closed for no, it is not operating, and there is a samples. String, hi there, CAC 2024, section A, group 2. This is the first line of the file and another line, and because it is finally executed, so it is closed the file. So I put it in a try. It is generally called in Java try catch block, but in Python it is called try except else and finally close. It is a try block. Then anything which exception might occur, for every exception you should write your block there with that exception, and if no exception then you can write else block, and if you have not declared anything, then you have everywhere you must everyone this portion of the code must be executed, so that is the finally clause. So wherever you are coming out with this code will be executed. So always better anything which is very urgent and you must close the file handling for a better performance of your program, you should put like this try catch block. So the file I have not opened, I make it fo.close. So this file is fantastic, it is running. Now we have to check it whether this code will run in Google Colab. It will run, just it is for our, because I always say sometimes you should do Colab. Yep. So Colab, where is Colab? Yeah. Is there. So what I'll do, I'll just make a plus code and copy paste, and this is our code, run it. Fine, same output, file name sample.txt, mode of operating write with binary file is closed, false. Hi there, CAC2024, a group 2. This is a this is file handling. A very good example is a threading. Probably threading I have discussed in your earlier classes, my YouTube classes. Threading is not there in C. That is a negative thing. But C runs on a bare machine, and Python, Java, all the modern day languages like Go, they run on a virtual machine. Because it's a virtual machine, you can have a threading concept, and it must be supported by operating system also. But even C you cannot have, because C runs on bare machine. Even the operating system supports threading, C cannot use much that, because then it differ to operating system to operating system. The portability of the C code will not be there. Probably that is the reason. Okay, the threading is, what is the concept? Is because I have, what is thread? Thread is nothing but mini task. What is mini task? It is a process. So whenever you write a program, because whenever we have a given problem, then you should start a programming. No, you should think about your algorithm first, an algorithm and data structure. Then you write the code as per the algorithm, which dictates which data structure. It may be linear array, or it may be binary tree or binary search tree, or tree or graph. So depends on that. If it is available in Python, in C, then you write in Python, because Python everything is dictionary, you know, all these things are there. Then you start coding, that is called the source code, that is extension in .py. Then you compile it or interpret it, and the file will be .pyc. And in Java it will be .class, and in Java it will run on Java virtual machine. Same as Python virtual machine, it will be PYC code is run on it. PYC code, you can always, it can run on any Python virtual machine. On our Android is also a Dalvik virtual machine, DVM. It is which course runs on JVM, it runs also Dalvik virtual machine. It's another clone of Java virtual machine, because Java is a kind of some copyright issue. Earlier Android supports Java, right now also, but they are now going for their own virtual machine, Dalvik virtual machine. Anyway, so what is the concept of threading? Threading is when the program is there, then whenever it is runs in the actual CPU or virtual machine CPU, we call it a task. And that if the your programming language, your virtual machine supports, from the main mother task, you can create sub tasks. You can call it a daughter task, They can also create that's called thread. So that is not called a task. A mother task is initiated. We have seen it. It's a main thread. Then we'll other daughter thread created. It is main for it. It is basically takes use of different cores of CPU, because in your CPU we have multi core, data quad core, octa core. So if you don't have that threading, then you can only use only one CPU in your mobile phone or your laptop or desktop. So threading is a great advantage. So because this kind of language can have threading, so you divide and conquer. You say certain portion of Word document, you open up in one document, another document, you search and find another, spell checking another. You distribute it to different thread and put it on different core CPU, and your program response will be faster. So, but in Python, that will make it import thread. But remember, the thread child or daughter thread has to be finished, or whenever mother thread died, all the daughter thread has to be died, or automatically should be done. So here we have import threading, that is Python, and I have a function, and what are the number is automatically return threads. I'm creating thread, and k in range 5, so I will be 1, 2, 3, 4, not 5. So whenever it's a common range comment, you should not go to the end of it. So I am creating a thread, and target coda argument, what is the value? K starts from 0, 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and we just threads that append t dot start. We like it here, the same as a Java thread, is concept is same. So try this code, our this thing, our PyCharm. Finish, and then we just paste. Hopefully, so what is there? Import threading has to be done. This is the function, you know, function colon and indentation. Indentation should be 4. Thread said this one. Let's try. This is run main. Yeah, it is running. Code is 0, 1, 2, 3. Somehow, here it's interesting. Because the threading running asynchronously, so code 4 comes earlier than 3, so actually it should be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, but it's come 43. It is nothing but code 3 and 4. Let's run once more, hopefully. Yeah, this time it is fine. So that is a thread concept I wish to tell you. The threading is asynchronous, so thread can run parallelly, and so that is it. So sometimes you get maybe 4 comes here, 2 comes here. It should not be, but they have initiated, 4 is initiated last. Hopefully most 99% 4 will be here. So exit code means it is same concept as C. Whenever the exit code is 0, that means program runs fine. So that is threading. So you can start, you can see it, whether how it is fair in our Colab. Go to Colab, yeah, and then we just plus code and paste. This is the file, and I just run it. Yeah, it is great. So it is Colab giving no problem. So this is it, and threading is a great concept. So you must this thing go for threading. Then another interesting thing I wish to show, that your decanter. Decanter, my earlier video is there, but you look into it. Decanter is nothing but, here I took it from another, the decanter import start. Now, all the things imported this thing, and we do not have a import decanter as a TK I have not used, so I have to always mention decanter. The parent TK, in earlier example I have used the root, but you whenever you see the various codes, you should accustom to it can be variable. So here is a parent, this particular site. So it should, and ultimately it will be parent dot bind. It will loop it. Otherwise it will once. So from decanter import start, red button, I create a button parent is the root. You in another program, text red and foreground color is the grid. Red button dot pack. So it like you are packing something in a, you have to use this pack. And where to pack? The left. The red button should be on the left. Green button takes black, black, left, right. Blue button, this one, and top button. Let's see how this program runs. From TK Intel, another interesting GUI. Yeah, hopefully it should run. Yeah, this is the, hopefully you can see it. Yeah, it's a bit too big. Too big. This is the, this is, hopefully it should run. Yeah, this is it. See, here red comes left, black, green. I have created a button. So, see, this is a look and feel of the button. This is excellent. This is very different. The button filling is there, and the parent, because I have not level anything, the ordinary TK num comes, so you know how to change this TK, and you have to go to. So here I want to interestingly show you that that we are using TK Intel full name, not TK, and we are creating in earlier program we had root, here is a parent, and at the end is the root dot parent dot main. The TK Intel program will not run in Colab, whatever I have found, so I am not trying it. So, great. So, my program TK Intel, same thing. Let's try this one, copy. What I am doing it here, import TK Intel, okay, from, not star, import, from TK Intel, import star, okay, I am importing everything. And with the top, I am creating, and top is a here, root is here, like top. So, run this. Here. But I will suggest that whenever you program, you make it the root. Here, the program is import TK Intel import star. I am importing everything. In earlier, I have some parent here. That format I root. Here, I name it top. So ultimately, top dot main loop should be there. I am creating a variable, check variable. So it's automatically checked. Int var, this is already a function is there in TK Intel, check var 2. Now TK Intel, the check button, I am creating a check button. I am not using TK, I am a TK Intel because I am using import TK Intel. TK Intel top text machine learning, variable check var, on value 1, off value 0. I see the off value here is 1, so you automatically check. I am putting a grid and so the sticky bit. All these things will be clear. Let's run this. Hopefully it will run. Yeah, this is see here, because deep learning, this button I have used of value 1, so it is ticked. Because it's a not radio button, it is it can be ticked. I can check it here, so that you can also make it ticked and grid. Is there machine learning text is coming by the check button, so you can create interesting GUI of your project of your with the TK Intel. Excellent program, you can check it. So I can do it on value, off value. I can check it. This one also one. This one hopefully I can make it. Yeah, fine. Now it should be off both on value 0 and off value should 1. Now you see both is ticked because of value 1 and both the case on value 0. So we've got TK Intel frame, the frame concept. What I have done import TK Intel, okay. I am creating a window, say earlier case root, sometimes parent is a window. So definitely window.main loop to be run because I have taken from another side. And say you have early, if you do not do only PK TK name is there, I want know it should do window title GUI. I can write a GUI for say your group name CSC. Yeah, earlier it would be TK. We'll first create a division with the help of a frame class. This frame class top frame, two frame, either top frame and bottom frame. Whatever you do it, then after all is packing, first get a division with the yes. Once the frame are created, I will all set with the both frame. Button 1, button 1, button 3. And these are interesting button. Red, green, purple, orange. And how they will be there. You have to, anytime you create a two frame, remember, top frame and bottom frame. And whenever you are creating a button 1, you tell where it will be. With the top frame, yeah. Button 2 also top frame. One is red and green in the top frame, yeah, and button 3 is bottom frame, it's the purple and orange, yeah, pack it from the side left, and let's try this program. Okay, just run it, yeah, this is the program. You can see that now it will come GUI for CC 202 section in group 2, because I have done window title here and I'm creating two buttons in the top frame. This is the top frame, this is the lower frame. So that is interesting. So yeah, button 1, button 2, this is fully script. So everything I copy and nothing done else. So let's see any other interesting program we can show you. Take Intel 1. And what I have done here, I go back to the earlier. It is better. Import TK, it is a TK, import TK into import TTK. You might ask why both this. TTK is a later version, and all the widget, this button, this sidebar, these are called widgets. They are better implemented in TTK, but not all. So it is better to import both. Import TK Intel as a TK, import from TK Intel, import TTK. So this line is meant for is the newer version of widget. You can, otherwise it will call for older version. Okay, that's it. Then the from TK Intel, import file dialog as empty. This is from TK Intel. From TK Intel message box, import show info, that I have covered. Then I have called root. I am creating a root TK from, this is the function root titles, TK Intel open function to make it interesting. CAC 2024 and roots resizable, false, so it cannot be root, cannot be, the frame cannot be resizable. And what is the root geometry? Here I make it, I wish to make it a little bigger so that you can make it see root geometry. I make it a 600 by 400, hopefully it will work. Yeah, then I created a function select file. File type text file, start.txt, yeah, all files start.txt, it's typical. File name, fd, ask open file name, these are all available in this thing. Title, open a file, root directory, what are the files, there. Show info, select a file, open a button. I am, see here I am using TTK button, not TK button. TTK button is much better, so it is a later version. Root, open a file, select a file, open button, expand true. Run the function. So here it will last is in loop, root.main. Hopefully this should run. Yeah, it is running. So here you see the TK Intel open file dialog CC 2024, and a single button comes. You need open file, automatically this thing will be coming. So this thing, if you want to do in a C file on Java, it will take lots of programming. But here you see in Python it is just a one or two lines. Everything is available in the library. So building a prototype in a Python open source is very, very easy. Almost all over the world now all the prototypes are written in Python. Probably you will be astonished. YouTube is total site is written in Python. Various Google sites, newer sites, maybe Google Map, latest version are written in Python or Go. They, because it is much easier to give a prototype function. Yeah, so we can, so this is a file, you just try to say my all source code is here in a separate, say I see Python docs. So this is the file, all our the Python is, it is selected file, information, not warning. It should display it. Okay, So in another program we find the whole that this is, yeah, this is a this code, now it is displayed. So what is the extra thing I had? Open button, TTK open a file, comment, this is the only thing, open open text file. Yeah, office content and text, so that you can write HTML code, it will automatically bold and all these things. This HTML head, body and all this, it will format it that way. Next day I will show you, but this code will run. This code will be run, so it done. So you can see the if it is outputted to one HTML browser, automatically only this thing will be printed. This is HTML body section, it will be bold. No such head body, because it is, I am outputting in a text window, so that's it. But if it's in a browser, you can see it in a border. So next day I'll show you, let's find some suitable examples. This one I wish to show. Any other interesting thing I want to show you? There's file handling I have shown you, object-oriented programming I have shown you, this thing, regular expression I'll show next day, regular expression I'll show next day. Any other interesting thing I am just checking? Training like an object, it I will show next day. Pickle I will show next day. Pickle, so that you can streaming data, we will show in a pickle format. Just show today. Pickle. Yeah, pickle it is. What is pickle? It is a kind of a format for streaming data, like sound, video, they are all streaming data that has to be maintained. I mean, this is, you have to just input pickle command. Right now the JSON is better. JSON is JavaScript of Ocean. So the both is Python support ports. Python original is pickle, but right now most of your app, Android app or Python based app, they have used, if it's purely Python, they can pickle, it is faster. But JSON, but pickle can take binary objects, because it can, if it's some password, and but JSON is only text file, only ASCII. But JSON is, it can go to various routers, you know, a binary file sometimes at router level it is banned. So this is what is a number. I'm creating a class, my object example class, my pickled object I dumps into a string, and this is my packed object dictionary. Then this is it. I'll just run it. Run it. Yeah, this is a dictionary of unpickled object. First A, this is a dictionary. First, because it's string A, second, two, third, one, two, three is the list. So this is a, you know, dictionary can contains first item would be always a immutable. It's a string immutable. Yes, this is also second immutable. It's immutable. But right hand is a list. It's a variable process. So what I have done, I am putting everything into a class, and I now and I put this my pickled object. So now whenever a pickled object, you can stream it, and later the receiver version, they can unpickle it. But so that whenever you have to put the streaming data, you must do it pickled mode, like YouTube data is JSON mode or something, because otherwise it will be strict ordering should be there. It is generally for streaming data it is used. So next day I'll some better example I'll show. This is right now a hands-on example we have. Then I hope this one text file I've done. This one I have shown you, but I wish to show you once again. I don't remember whether I have shown it or not. This is a password. I think I have shown you. Just try once more. This is almost the class is it. This is. Yeah. So here is a password. How to see here? Username, password. So I have given the SRC. The password I made was to A, B, C. DC start is coming. So all this GUI, it is not, I am not putting action onto it. All this there in the code. So what is there? TK enters a TK. Remember, import TK because it's a super class. Not super, it is a more advanced. So TTK implementation are better. Even if we omit this line, your program will run. So I am sure it is a class concept because it is an object-oriented programming class. I'm creating a geometry title resizable, create gadgets. This is a use of main function. Remember, Python doesn't need main. Like Java needs main, program needs main. But whenever Java applet programming, there is no concept of main. Applet is running in browser. But here you can optional. Main can be main optional. So actually program starts here. I am creating an app with a class app and I make it a loop. The program is much more readable. That's the advantage. In earlier program, you have to have a lot of codes. Here, you have everything put into a class. Everything you put into a class and it is reusable. And I am doing this. Okay. So with this, I am ending the class. And what we have just a little bit, what we have.
So this is the total number of cases currently in the world, deaths and recovered. If we can enter any country, it will give the data of that particular country.
Sure.
From this, we can get the total number of cases. That's 34 million and deaths.
Request.
Yeah, import request. BS4 for our, since we are doing HTML parsing, we need BS4 for beautifying the HTML. Install Tinker for graphic user interface. And date and time, because the data we have inputting is really changed every time. So now here we have we are getting the URL that we have inputted in this. This is the official website for COVID. And from that website, what we are doing the HTML using Beautify Soup. What we do is that we are using an HTML parser so that we can distinguish between the different elements of the HTML. And then from that we are seeing what we need. For instance, we need the COVID data, which is under div and class content inner.
Okay.
So we are searching for that particular thing, and within that we are searching the main counter wrap. It's basically in the website. If we go in any website and we see the inspect button, we can actually understand as to how the websites are made and whoever have made it. And from that website we have taken the text, that is the here the coronavirus. Virus test word, and the count is the number of cases.
Okay.
And all details we are concatenating the string coronavirus plus the text plus the number.
Okay.
And then we are returning this all data.
Okay.
Same thing goes for the country as well. Here we are just entering the country name as a separate tag.
Okay.
The reload function, where once I reload the data, it will go on to the original data. So reload function. With this reload function, which go on to the original data. Now here too, we are simply creating the graphic user interface
window. Contact management system.
Good.
So this is the code.
Okay.
If we run the code,
then
1 minute, sir.
Very good.
This
page
will appear. This page will appear.
Yeah.
There one detail is already added. So if we want to add more details, there we have to give the name. Male, age 21. If we save, then the contact will appear here. Contact will be updated in this space. And if we want to delete one, then we have to select this and delete. Yes. Details will be deleted automatically. So,
one is the chatbot one. Sir, it is the notepad file which is it is working on.
Great.
Sir, we have created a voice. So,
allow me to introduce myself. I am Jarvis, a virtual artificial intelligence, and I am here to assist you in a variety of tasks, as best as I can, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, importing all database from main server. Systems now fully operational. Good afternoon, sir. How may I help you?
What is the time?
Sir, the time is 16 hours, 2 minutes and 10 seconds.
Who is Amitabh Bachchan?
Searching. According to Wikipedia, Amitabh Bachchan is an Indian actor, occasional playback singer, film producer, television personality, and former politician who works in Hindi films. He made his acting debut in 1969 with Sa Hindu's Tani and narrated Mrinal Sen's Vivan Show, 1969.
Search YouTube for Spider-Man. YouTube search Spider-Man.
Searching. Spider-Man. This is what I found, sir.
Play music.
Tracking the location of a phone number. So if we run this code, we get this window.
Object detection. So our project is live moving object detection or live object detection, sir.
Good.
Okay, sir. Live came on. Okay. This is an object find, sir. Personal call.